Hey there, I'm Allie of Fully Fit by Allie, and this is Fully Grounded. Welcome. We'll begin with a brief meditation today, so find yourself a comfortable seat, either cross-legged, maybe you want something supporting your back, sitting on a cushion perhaps, or even just lying flat on your back on your mat. And we will come to eyes closed, just beginning with a deep inhale through the nose. And exhaling with a sigh, just letting everything settle. I want you to picture either a small version of yourself, or maybe your soul, or inner child, higher self, whatever works best for you, maybe even God, if that resonates with you. Just picture that light being living in your heart space. Just kind of cozying up, if you can picture kind of a little cartoon of someone getting cozy on a couch, and that's just the space within your own body, in your heart center. We're just breathing into that space, trying to comfort the being that's there. Just finding that homey, cozy spot within yourself as you continue breathing. Just giving love to that inner child or soul. And as we continue with our breaths, breathing into the heart space, allow your body to soften with each exhale, releasing the muscles of the face, the jaw, the shoulders, the hips, the belly, the legs, fingers and toes. Just gently breathing into each spot, softening as much as you can. Remember, thoughts will naturally come into your mind. It's completely normal. There's no need to try and push them away. Just acknowledge them and send them on their way. We can think about everything later when we're not spending time with our own body and mind. Just taking any vibrational breaths that feel good. You know, I love my HAs and HMs. Whatever feels really, really luscious in your body. We'll spend a few moments in silence here, just breathing, softening, making space for your soul within your body. Simply rest as deeply as you can. Friends, let's slowly open our eyes, come back into our bodies. How's it going? Well, let's get into the movement portion. Today we're going to dive a little farther into our vinyasa practice, adding a couple basic poses like the warrior sequences, but we will start on our backs, getting a little prep work in. So let's make our way there onto the back. We'll start with the knees into the chest. You can have them as wide or close together as you'd like. And we'll take a gentle rock side to side. Keeping those nice deep breaths the whole time. I know sometimes when we start moving, it's hard to remember to breathe. All right, from here, let's roll all the way onto one side of your body. You're going to have your hips stacked and your shoulders stacked. We're going to take one arm all the way out, following with your eyes. And then we take it back over. So a nice big yawn of the shoulder, gazing at the fingertips with your eyes. And back. And we're keeping the hips completely still here. So we're just twisting through the thoracic spine. And we'll do one more on this side. Good. And back. Let's switch to the other side. You'll get to see my back. So we're all the way over. Hips are stacked, shoulders are stacked. Opening up that arm. Following with the eyes. And back. You might find you're able to maybe touch the ground with one hand and possibly not with the other. That's perfectly normal, as we are extremely asymmetrical beings. That's all good. Beautiful. Let's do one more on this side. And over. Good. Back onto our backs here. We'll take hands down by the sides, palms flat down. Ground the feet in, let's bridge the hips up. Nice and slow, rolling tailbone, middle back, upper back. Once you get to the top here and your hips are nice and high, we'll take opposite arm and leg up and then switch to the other side before rolling down. One vertebra at a time, tucking the tailbone as you roll. Good, come right back up. One vertebra at a time, articulating through the spine. We get two marches, right arm, left leg, left arm, right leg, and rolling back down to the floor. We got eight more of these guys, so keep going. Do our marches, and rolling down. Guys, you should feel the glutes working, the hamstrings are doing some work, the core is working. Lots of stuff going on here, practicing some balance and strength at the same time. Looking good. Keep on going here. If you've been doing the same left-right for the marches, let's switch it up here. So instead of left-right, go right-left or vice versa. If you've been alternating each time, good for you. Rolling up. Looking great, guys. We'll do about four more here. And down. We definitely don't want to rush through these. Getting the full benefit of the movement requires a little bit of slow pace. Let's take two more. Get our marches. Articulating through the spine on the way down. Excellent, nice work. From here, let's take a quick spinal twist, drop the left leg flat to the ground, right knee comes across the body, and we'll bring that right arm out to the side, glancing over the right shoulder, just twisting through the whole body. Nice and gentle, don't push too much here. And let's bring that knee back to center. We'll extend the right leg, left knee comes across the body. And we'll bring that left arm out to the side, glancing over the left shoulder. Nice deep breaths. Got a nice little adjustment in my low back. Maybe you will too, depending on what you've done for movement today. It's always fun when I get my first stretch in for the day. It's like snap, crackle, pop, Rice Krispies all over the place. Got noisy joints. Good, let's bring it back to center here. Doing awesome, guys. Let's bring the right foot up in the air. We're keeping the left foot grounded. And we'll do some little hip circles. So we're really focusing not just on moving the leg, but also tucking the tailbone slightly underneath, so we're engaging the low muscles of the core. That little strip of ab muscles right above your pubic bone should be working here, if you want to test it out and feel. You can go for it. Let's switch directions of the circles here. You can make them as small or big as you want, as long as they're controlled and you feel your core working. And let's switch feet. Taking that left foot for a little circle spin. Engaging the lower core. And we're breathing. So reverse the direction of your circle. Looking great. Let's take the feet down. Good stuff here. So what we will do now is take both legs up in the air, and you're going to do a separation of the feet. So feet come apart, then they go down, come together, and up. So apart, down, together, up. And we're trying to really keep that low back grounded to the mat. It'll make the abs work a little extra for you if you don't let the back pop off the ground. I'm accidentally taking my dish towel for a ride with my foot. We'll do one more, and then we're reversing the circle, dropping both feet down, out and around, back, up, down, out, around, and up. Let's take three more. There's two. And one. Nice job. Hug those knees back into the chest. If you want to take the hands behind the knees this time, we'll get into our rolling like a ball. So we're curling through the spine, tucking those feet towards the head, and then coming to sit up, not letting the toes touch the floor. So we're back and we're up. We're going to take 10 of those total. Here's 8. Try and really balance those sits bones. Once you get up, feet off the ground. 6. There's 5. Doing great, guys. Keep breathing. There's 4. And 3. On the last one, we're going to separate the feet at the top of the mat and come into a squat. So we're we got to try that again. All the way to the top. So we're in a nice deep squat. Feet are just about as wide as the mat. And we're going to sit those hips nice and low, opening up the chest. My elbows are pressing into the inside of my knees. And just hang out here for a second and breathe. That was fun. I don't always get it right the first time. So you can see I'm perfectly human myself. Gotta give it 2 shots sometimes. Good stuff. Let's take the hands to the mat. We're stretching those hips towards the ceiling. Bend the knees if you need to. Just take a little sway side to side. Good. Let's keep the right foot where it is. We're going to step the left foot way back. So keeping that knee off the ground, we're leading our chest forward towards the top of the mat. So we got both hands down, opening up these hips here. You can do a little circle if you want, a little saw up and down. Good, and then bend the back knee, step that foot back in, back to our squat here. Elbows pressing to the insides of the knees, palms together at heart center. Deep breath, sitting the tailbone down, chest is up. And hands back to the mat, hips up, knees bent if you need to. This time we step the right foot back nice and long, keeping the knee off the ground. Can do our little circles or saws, whatever feels good for you. Just take it for a ride, see what happens. All right, let's bend the right knee. We'll step that foot all the way back in, come back to your squat. So we'll do that once more on each side. First, starting with palms down, hips up. Nice big forward fold here. Take that left foot back, keeping the knee off the ground. We'll do our little hip circles here. Good, bending the back knee, stepping in, full squat. Hips down, palms at heart center, elbows pressing on the insides of the knees. Let's take those hands down, forward fold. A little sway side to side here, wagging your tail. And we'll take that right leg back, nice long lunge, knee off the ground. And take those circles if you'd like them. So excited. At one point we might even be able to start doing this outside. It's getting nice out, guys. Who's psyched? I know I am. Bend that back knee, step it in, and we'll take that squat one last time here. Looking really great. Hands to the ground, take that forward fold, hips up, and turn your toes back in to be parallel. So we can still keep the feet just about as wide as the mat, but we will parallel our toes out so they're not splayed out to the sides. Good, really plant those hands. We'll step back into a high plank here. Shoulders right over the elbows, over the wrists. Got my hips in line with my shoulders. Keeping that core nice and tight from here, pushing back into down dog. Hips come up nice and high, heels towards the floor. Keep the knees bent if you'd like. That's always available to you if you need it. From here, rolling forward into high plank. Big inhale. And exhale, down dog. Three more, rolling forward, high plank. Really pressing into all parts of the hand there as you exhale, hips up, down dog. Here's two, rolling forward. Exhaling back. Inhale forward. Exhale back. Great work, guys. Let's ground the right toes, lift the left heel, keeping both hips squared towards the ground. We'll pause for a moment and then inhale, open up the hips, stacking one on top of the other. We'll circle through the ankle there. Nice big hip yawn. Let's point those toes. Take the toes back down to the mat. Other side, raising the right leg. Going for a length, both hips square to the ground. And then we'll open up that hip. You can bend the knee, roll through the ankle. And let's take those toes all the way back up to point. And down, good. From here, inhale, bend the knees, take a walk all the way to the top of the mat. Once you get there, let those knees bend. We'll hang in a forward fold, releasing the muscles of the head and the neck. Two big breaths at the top of the mat. Good. Hands to the shins. Inhale, half lift, flat back. Exhale, release, forward fold, bend the knees, roll on up, arms come up overhead. I know you can't see them, I'm sorry guys. Exhale to drag hands down to heart center, and let's close the eyes just for a moment here, feeling what it's like to be fully grounded into the earth, rooting those heels down, root to rise, getting that spine nice and tall on top of your base. Good, open up the eyes, big inhale, arms sweep back overhead, exhale, forward fold. Good, inhale, half lift, hands to the shins, nice flat spine. Exhale, hands plant, step back to plank, and we'll go through our flow. For those of you who don't remember, I'll show you the basic version. Starting on the knees, as you exhale, you come all the way to the floor, elbows go behind you. As you inhale, we come into cobra, using the back strength to raise the chest. And we exhale back into down dog. Now, one more time for those of you who are a little more advanced. We take our inhale to press the mat away from a high lunge. Exhale, elbows by the ribs, chaturanga. Inhale, upward facing dog, flipping the tops of the toes down. As you exhale, down dog. Good. We'll do this two more times. Little sun salute, bending the knees. Take a walk to the top of the mat. Exhale to arrive in your forward fold. Drop the head, let it go. Inhale, hands to shins, flat back. Exhale, release, forward fold. Roll on up, big inhale, arms overhead, palms pressed. Exhale, drag down to heart center. Inhale, arms sweep back overhead. Exhale to fold. Inhale, half lift, flat back. Exhale, hands down. Step the feet back to plank and go through your flow. Whichever version you like is perfectly fine. As long as it feels good, keeping all your joints safe. One more turn here. Inhale, bend the knees, walk to the top of the mat. Exhale, forward fold, looking great. Inhale for that half lift, flat back. Exhale, release, fold forward. Inhale, roll up. Arms overhead, palms pressed. Exhale, heart center. Big inhale, sweep those arms up overhead. Exhale, dive forward. Inhale, half lift. Exhale, hands grounded, step your feet back and flow. Chaturanga to up dog. And down dog. Beautiful job, guys. Take a couple breaths here. Pedal through the feet. Do what you gotta do. And we're gonna get into some warrior poses. So let's inhale that right leg up and back. Exhale, step it through between the hands. Spiral your back heel down and we'll come on up, raising the body into warrior one. We're gonna take a look at the hips and see if we can square them forward. Arms are up, palms facing towards one another. We're really pressing through the back outside edge of that back heel so that we can straighten out the leg and guide our hips to be square forward. On your next exhale, open up warrior two. You might need a little wider stance here. Hips are going to be squared to the side. So, nice big breaths, really activating the arms, pressing the palms down so we get the triceps engaged. Deep breaths, gazing over that right hand. And your next exhale, we'll cartwheel the hands down, step your foot back, go through your flow. Same thing, other side. Inhale, left leg up. Exhale, step it through between the hands, ground the right heel. Inhale, up, warrior one. Left knee is over the ankle. We're guiding those hips towards the front of the mat. Nice deep breaths. Next exhale, open up warrior two. So we're facing the side now, gazing over the left fingertips, engaging through the arms, dropping the shoulders down the back. Big inhale, exhale, cartwheel those hands down. We'll step the left foot back and flow. Good work. Inhale, right leg up. Exhale, step it through between the hands. Keep the back heel lifted this time. We'll come on up and do a crescent lunge, keeping that back leg straight. We're high on the ball of the left foot. Deep breaths here. Looking awesome, guys. From here, ground the back heel. We'll flip it. You're going to take your hands behind you, power lunge. So the palms are down towards the ground. We're really lunging deep into that front knee. Gaze is just a foot in front of the toes. Nice. From here, let's sweep those arms all the way up, warrior one. Big inhale, exhale, hands to the ground. Step that right foot back, go through your flow. Inhale, left leg up. Exhale, step it through between the hands. Keep that back heel lifted. Inhale, the arms up, palms towards each other, shoulders down the back, crescent lunge. Nice and strong. Both hips are forward. From here, spin that back heel down. Arms come back, power lunge. Like big wings behind you. Palms face the ground, gazing over the toes. Next, inhale. Arms come up, warrior one. As you exhale, hands come down to the floor. Step the left foot back and flow. Let's sit back into a child's pose. Give ourselves a little tiny break here, a little intermission before we continue. Good. Let's ground the hands. We'll tuck the toes. Get those hips back up. Looking good, guys. Inhale, right leg up. Exhale, step it through. We'll spiral the left heel down. Inhale, warrior one. Right away, exhale, warrior two. Holding out those arms. Gazing over the right fingertips. Looking excellent. From here, I'm going to have you straight in the front leg. We'll spin the toes towards the front. So now we're in a nice wide-legged stance. Feet are parallel. From here, taking the hands to the hips, slowly dive forward, bending at the hips, all the way down. Good. From here, we can either grab outside the ankles. If you'd like, you can go into an inversion. If you like headstand, you can try that. Or we can walk the hands between the legs, getting a little more length in the spine here. Just totally releasing all the muscles of the neck. And let's take the hands back to the hips. Swan dive up. Taking yourself back, we're going to turn those toes back to the front. And out into warrior two we come. One big inhale here to spread your limbs apart. As you exhale, cartwheel the hands down. We'll step the foot back and flow. Good. Inhale, left leg up. Exhale, step it through between the hands. Spiral the right heel down. Inhale, up, warrior one. Right away, we exhale into warrior two. Nice deep breaths here. Keeping those arms engaged. Straighten out the left leg. Turn the toes towards the back. Now you get a nice view here. We're going to take the same forward fold, bending at the hips, coming all the way down. Hands can come to the outsides of the ankles or the feet. Just hanging out, upside down. My favorite way to be. Keep those breaths going, guys. You're doing awesome. Hands back to the hips here. We'll bring ourselves all the way back up. Turn those left toes back towards the front. Nice deep bend in the knee. Warrior two from here. Big inhale. As you exhale, hands cartwheel down. Step the foot back and go through your flow. Nice and slow. Each breath you have another movement. Good. From here, bend the knees. Look towards the front of the mat. Take a walk all the way to the top. Once you're there, we'll do a half lift. Big inhale. Exhale to fold forward and then bend the knees, roll all the way up. Good. So we'll get into a little bit of balancing since last week we prepped for balances in the video I did. So we'll introduce tree pose here. So we're going to ground into the right leg. We can either take the left foot inside the ankle or the calf. Or if you want to take it all the way up inside the thigh, that's great. Just not pressing against the inside of the knee. so we can protect the joint. I'm sorry, I know my view is a little off, so you can't see the top of my head, but we'll be okay. Hands at heart center, if you're feeling comfortable. And from here, we're just really strengthening through that right leg, grounding through the earth. And now we're going to grow our branches, taking those arms up overhead. Maybe even finding a smile. I know I'm a cheese ball. Keep those arms reaching. If you want to challenge yourself and take a glance up towards the ceiling, you can take on that little challenge. And then we'll get those hands back together, down to heart center. And you can release the foot. We'll try the other side. So grounding through that left leg, right ankle, I'm sorry, right foot can either be at the ankle, calf, or all the way inside the thigh. So same thing, grounding through that entire left leg. We'll take the hands to heart center and then grow our branches all the way up. I like to separate my arms at the top. You can do whatever feels good for you. And again, taking a little glance up if you'd like it. It's always kind of fun to challenge yourself. If you fall, you've got one leg that's pretty close to the ground. You can just put that right foot back down. It's all good. Learning how to balance teaches us humility. I think it's really important for everyone to have a little bit of humility. And I'll take those hands back down to heart center. We'll release that right foot. And we'll come back to the top of the mat. You guys are killing it today. Hands all the way down. We'll step into our high plank. And go straight back into down dog here. Whee! Looking good. Let's inhale the right foot up. We're going to bend the knee and send it to the top right corner of the mat. Knee is outside the line of the hip. And the left leg is long behind us like a tail. So take a little look back if it's out to one side. See if you can get it back into line. We're going to extend through the chest, just opening up, maybe even looking up before we come on down to the forearms or whatever's comfortable here. Some of you may find this really cozy. Some people might be like, why are you making me do this? Just getting some stretching into that right glute and hip here. Take a couple moments. Keep that breath with you. Let's come back up to the hands here and make your way over to the other side, whichever way feels most natural to you. I'll just make sure that left knee is outside the line of the hip as we're aiming for that left shin to be parallel to the top of the mat. I'm not there yet. You might be. It's all good. Just checking for that long tail of a right leg behind you before we open up that chest. Looking up at the ceiling and then slowly reclining down onto the forearms. Just take a few deep breaths here. Let's come back up and just swing that right leg around. I'm going to swing around to the front with you guys. We can finish up. Just having you take the left leg out in front of you here, and we're going to try and get that right foot to the outside of the left knee. Just using that left arm to hug the knee in, and you can take that right arm behind your seat so you can prop yourself up a little more for the twist, glancing over the right shoulder here. Just really squeezing everything in, compressing so that we can have new oxygen flow when we release the position. Really sitting up tall through the spine as you twist. And we'll come back to center, sending the right foot out. Left foot comes to the outside of the right knee, using the right arm to hug that knee in. Left arm comes right behind your seat, helping to elongate the spine. Glancing over the left shoulder. Keep those nice breaths going. And come on back to center here. We have one last bit of core work and then I'll let you go for the day. So we'll start with our boat pose, taking the feet off the ground, leaning back on the sits bones, chest is still up. So we're going from here and then lengthening the legs, lowering the upper body. We're not hitting the ground quite yet. Bring yourself back up and then we lower, lengthen, hover. Head and toes are off the ground. Doing awesome. Lower, lengthen, hover, and up. Three more. Lower, lengthen, hover, and up. Here's two. And up. Last one. And up, good. Hug those knees and we'll come onto the back. Let yourself relax all the way out into Shavasana. I'm gonna let you stay here as long as you would like if you want to pause the video and chill out. But I will say goodbye and thank you to you now. So as always, thank you so much for joining me. I hope that you got a little bit out of this video. If there's anything that you were confused with, feel free to comment in the video or send me a message. I'd love if you could subscribe, comment, share, like, and if you're able to donate, my Venmo information is in the description of the video. So thank you again so much. Have an awesome day, and I'll catch you next week. Namaste.